Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This is a very special episode about the changes to the upcoming Academy Awards. The changes were just announced last week, and today I'm going to talk about some of the implications of those changes. Now, here on The Review, I always offer my recommended viewing guide to see it, stream it, or skip it. I can say right out the gate that I will still be watching the Academy Awards. I have watched them every year that I can remember. And for the last couple of years, my wife and I have seen all of the Best Picture nominees. As you know from watching The Review, I certainly love going to the movies. I love seeing movies. I have been watching them as long as I can remember. And one of my favorite things has been to see as many movies as I can. And that way, when the Academy Awards come around, I can be as much of an informed viewer as possible. As I was getting ready for this episode, I realized that one of the reasons that I enjoy seeing all the movies that I can before the Oscars is because the Oscars are pretty much my Super Bowl. As a movie lover, I definitely wait all year to see the Academy Awards. There are certainly other award shows in the run-up to it and around different parts of the year that I enjoy as well. The Academy Awards are clearly the most prestigious award ceremony for film. And with that, I do think that these upcoming awards are going to change the tone and feel of the show going forward. Now, some dates to keep in mind to get ready for the show as it comes. The nominations for this upcoming year are going to come out on January 22nd. Among those nominees, there will be nominations for a new category, the popular film category. And a lot has been said about that. My personal feelings, and I will elaborate a little bit more, are that because the category is not defined yet, we don't know what will constitute a popular movie for this category, it was probably announced a little bit too soon. Honestly, seems that they let the cat out of the bag. We're going to get a lot of time to think about it before we know what they mean by that. And it definitely, in my opinion, takes away from the prestige of the Best Picture nominees. I do wonder, as the show goes, for the pacing, when this award will be given out. If it's given out last, it would certainly seem to undermine the Best Picture nominees. And if it's given out before then, it seems counterintuitive to making people watch the show. If it's for the popular films, I would imagine that you would want to put it at a part of the show where you can make the most people watch up until then. I just think it's a really cheap idea. I think that they could have explored other options. And another one of the announcements was that they are going to keep themselves to a tight 3-hour telecast. And again, as someone who thinks of this more or less similar to my Super Bowl, I don't need it to be short. This is on once a year. I don't mind if it goes a little bit over. I'm worried about what they will sacrifice to come into that runtime. I'm interested in seeing every speech. I feel like those awards are given and those speeches are an opportunity to express yourself in a way that many creative film professionals have either been working towards their whole life or since their last win. I love those speeches. I just can't imagine that they decide that was a place to cut time is some of the speeches. If anything, certainly remove every song that isn't nominated for something. When they have songs being performed during the Oscars that are not nominated, I don't understand. And those are pieces I would certainly cut. It just seems like they rushed it. It seems like they let the cat out of the bag way too early. Why announce a category unless you're going to tell us what makes it? If it's only about box office revenue, it removes the need to nominate these movies because we're already going to know what's nominated. It just seems like a real swing and a miss. I can't understand why they would make this decision. We will know what won on February 24th, but just until then, I looked into some other ways that they could have changed it that other award ceremonies have done to trim time and kind of tighten the awards. One of my favorite changes is the MTV Movie Awards has combined the performance award categories. They've removed the gender from it, and it's best performance in a movie. really cool. They've had it for 2 years now. They've had Emma Watson win for Beauty and the Beast, and they had Chadwick Boseman win for Black Panther earlier this year. If you're looking for a way to trim time, I think that would be a more interesting way than to introduce a category that pretty much, to me, seems like we're going to have our fancy movies, and all of you plebs that didn't see any of these fancy movies can like at least have a category that we'll talk about. It really bummed me out. The SAG Awards have another really cool category, but it would be an additional one. They give an award for best performance by a cast. It's one of my favorite awards. I think that it's super cool, and I just feel like the Oscars have let me down. Like I said, I will certainly be watching it. It is available to stream, and so will the full awards ceremony online. I will be watching it. I will certainly be keeping you up to date on it. And just a reminder, here on the review, I am keeping my own tally of my favorite performances of the year. So far, we got Michelle Williams in I Feel Pretty and Jesse Plemons in Game Night, 1-2 favorite performances of the year. I'll be keeping you posted on that as well here on the review. My name is Johnny Vaught. Thank you for watching.